first met Bill Hamilton in Oxford, just on the eve of his fatal Congo expedition. He had wanted to discuss methods of chimp fecal sample collection with me. It was a meeting the import of which didn't sink in for quite some time. Bill Hamilton felt that the reason separate species exist generally is to protect against viral or parasite transfer, and yet commercial biomedical interests were mixing genes and cells of different species and almost a blind and blinded by the greed. And he felt that such experiments could be very dangerous for human future, as he wrote once, could conceivably deny humans having a future. I guess I was so much in awe of meeting a biologist considered by all of us evolutionary biologists as the greatest since Darwin that the full import of what he said just didn't really sink in, that AIDS could be a medical mistake, the greatest scientific disaster in human history, that one of the greatest scientific biological minds of the last century was going to Congo to investigate this hypothesis, and he had with him an assistant chosen for his French-speaking abilities. Him, I do remember, because there was something very strange about his assistant, the silence, the uneasy way in which he sat. It was almost like seeing a thug or a goon wearing a cop's uniform, where somehow the face and the uniform, something seems disjointed, something seemed wrong about the whole situation. It was a few months later when I read that Bill Hamilton had died on that expedition, and who would have thought that chimpanzee shit could change my life so much.
I just want them to understand a little bit about the theory and what we are doing.
This is one year cooler. Okay.
Okay.
So say that in the 1950s, the Belgians collected chimps from this region and the other type of chimps, bonobos, from this region. Then they took them to a region here near Lindi, and they said that they were making a dawa
to cure polio.
And then they fed this dawa in Rwanda and Bujumbura in this region. It was then Stanleyville, now it's called Kisangani. And they fed it in Kinshasa, the capital. Within 10 years of the places where they fed this dawa, the first cases of SIDA started to appear.
This experimental oral polio vaccine called CHAT was fed in Central Africa, in the countries now known as the Congo, Rwanda and Burundi, between 1957 and 1960. There is strong circumstantial evidence to suggest that some batches of this vaccine were prepared in a tissue culture of chimpanzee cells, and we now know that the common chimpanzee is the host to the virus, which is the direct ancestor to HIV-1. So what I'm proposing is that inadvertently this particular vaccine introduced the ancestor of HIV-1 into Homo sapiens.
I have no knowledge about it. I don't think the Belgians have knowledge about it. You should take his evidence with a grain of salt.
The idea that this great triumph, and it certainly was a wonderful triumph of defeating polio, was accompanied by a disaster as big as AIDS, and obviously it knocks you off your plinth of success to have to admit that this even might have happened, let alone that it actually did happen. And I seem to encounter this every time I talk to people who are connected with medical science. They just don't want to hear about this theory.
Is there a possibility here? Scientists simply don't want to know, don't want to accept perhaps at least the moral, if not the legal liability for what has been done for the AIDS virus.
I feel that this is so, and it's one of the most worrying aspects of the case. I feel it's not only the origin of AIDS that is in question here, it is the conduct of science towards this hypothesis, which has been one of almost paranoid rejection, I would say. I think I would not exaggerate to describe it as medical science's worst hated hypothesis, and there seems to be a great reluctance to publish anything about it or to test any of the available evidence that could be more directly tested.
Between 4 years and 20 years, we see the first emergence of HIV-1 group M, that's the type which has caused 50 million infections worldwide and tragically 15 million deaths from AIDS. We begin to see HIV-1 and AIDS emerging in those areas. The correlations are actually quite dramatic. Out of the first 46 instances of HIV-1 infection, proven infections from blood samples looked at retrospectively, 45 involved people who had come from towns or villages within 90 miles of the very places where this chat vaccine was fed at the end of the 50s.